So our house, where I have grown up, is comprising of all things that a typical Maharashtrian wada would consist of. Except imagine all those things to be crammed in an apartment, tucked away in a place that is densely populated with middle-class Maharashtrians called Dadar. A shelf lined with copper containers, a mori to wash utensils in, a big Devghar, a toilet which is very well within the limits of our own home, but we still prefer calling it Parsa Kade. And I know half of my friends don't even know what that means. Everything about this house is the reason why I identify myself as an old soul. And adding more verses to this poetry of my life is the fact that I grew up with my grandparents. Now, you would think I must have had it easy with them because, you know, grandparents are gullible towards their grandchildren's hattipana, right? Not mine. From my 7 p.m. curfews that gave me my Cinderella moments. And remember, there was no way of sneaking in, okay? Because he would always wait to open the door for me. To scolding me for not studying, to brainwashing me into picking science as a stream, to basically holding his ground against everything that I was willing to pursue. My grandfather, Bhau, as we call him, and I had a strangely strained relationship. We had this can't live with, can't live without situation going on, but more on that later. So this house I told you about, that was my vacation home until I started living here. And as a child, I had learned to entertain myself because my sister and I grew up away from each other for 10 years of our lives. So I'm often told that I give a lonely child vibe, which ticks my sister, who is my best friend, off. I'm sorry, Tai. Anyway, so every time I used to visit my grandparents during my summer breaks, I used to discover one new thing. And I kid you not, this house was like a treasure chest. You blow off a heap of dust from one some long forgotten drawer and you would find something that you would have never known about. That for me became a self-entertainment activity. I discovered a bunch of flutes, a tabla, a microphone, a film camera, all of which, by the way, belonged to my grandfather, who was and is still very keen of learning new things. So during one such summer break, I made a life-changing discovery. Okay, we had a tape recorder, which was the size of a television set, and it had two inputs for cassettes and a recording button. I put in a cassette of Kaho Na Pyar Hai in it and pressed on the button, and I was confused as to why nothing was playing. But I waited until side A finished. I tried to rewind it, and I played it again, only to realize that all the conversations in the living room were taped on that cassette. That felt like winning a lottery to me. I asked Bhau to repair the microphone I discovered a few moons ago for me, and I started taping myself on cassettes. I sang, I rambled, I pretended like I was a jockey of my own radio show. And I think all of these discoveries subconsciously led me to find my love for the performing arts. I sang on the microphone, I tried my hand at the flute, I rehearsed winning speeches in front of the mirror, I even practiced some dance moves from films that I watched on the VCR that Bhau showed us. And all of this was considered cute, huh? And was encouraged in front of my guests because the clown was always ready to take the spotlight, right? Until I decided to pursue this for real. That's when hell broke loose and Cinderella here got her reality check. None of this was legit. It was all fun and games and was supposed to be kept as that. But चांगल्या घरातल्या मुलींना शिक्षण संपवतात, नोकरी करतात, लग्न करतात आणि छान सुखाचा संसार करतात. It's what my Ajji once told me. And obviously, Bhau was not going to entertain my entertainment industry dreams. Hence, the strained relationship. We fought, we argued, we debated, we finally came up with a negotiation that he should give me some time to figure this out for myself. With a lot of resentment, he agreed. So I learned music for some time, I learned Kathak, I tried my hand at an instrument, I obviously started auditioning, and finally I started getting gigs on the internet. Except, Bhau was perpetually in disbelief of the legitimacy of my work because I never flashed on his TV screen. So, in honor of the keeper of all my childhood treasures, I decided to return him the favor of new discoveries. So, I got him hooked to a smartphone And luckily for me, his willingness of learning new things and curiosity of owning new gadgets made it easier for me to teach him how to look me up on the internet. So one evening, I came back home from somewhere and I saw that he was watching a video of my cup song having made its way to a Marathi news channel. So I nonchalantly just walked to the kitchen to get myself a glass of water until I heard a reverberating Mithila. The same authoritative kind, which basically meant trouble. So without wasting a second, I ran to the living room to find a smiling Bhau who said to me, "Ata tu news channel var alis na? Ata tu famous honar." That twinkle in his eyes was the only pat on the back that I craved for and I needed. The man who showed me most resistance didn't even realize how he was actually the enabler by being the carrier of my dreams through his own. Thank you, Bhau, for being the first one to show off all my articles and magazine covers to every guest and letting me take center stage just as you would when I was young. Thank you, Bhau, for watching this video until the end, just as patiently as you're waiting for me to come back home right now so you can open the door for me like always. Pan sorry, mala aaj ushir honar aahe, ha? Tu please zopunza, mi nighale ki phone karte.